Okay, we're up to Hey Amid Base. We're up to Hey Amid Base, and we're doing the sugya about a chazaka. A person doesn't pay mitoch zmanai. We had a machlokes between Reish Lakish and Abaye Varava. Reish Lakish says if a person said he paid mitoch zman, he didn't. Halavai should pay after this man, right? And Abaye Varava said no. A person is believed to go ahead and pay mitoch zman. We passing the halacha is like Reish Lakish, ad kedei kach that even if the leiva died, they would be able to collect from Yisaimim. If we won't say that, why even though we don't collect from Yisaimim, we won't say that why that the leiva paid mitoch zman. But Ella, the chazak is so strong that they'll be able to collect the chayv from the Yisaimim because the father didn't pay up. So Gemara is the following shaila. So again, here's the chazak guy. The chazak is a guy who doesn't pay mitoch zman. A chazak, the guy doesn't pay mitoch zman. He boiluhu. Tavu la'achazman. After this man is over, he says, where's my money? And he tells him, I paid you in the middle of this man. Now, what happens if he would have told him, I paid you bisman? Would he have been believed?
Yes.
Sure he would have been. If he says, I paid you in this man, meaning in the right time, he would have been believed, right? He would have been believed. So, but what did he say? He said, pay me toichsman now. So we have a chazaka that a person doesn't pay what? Mitoch zman. On the other hand, we have a migu, believe me that I paid up. Migu, I could have said I paid bismanoy and I would have been believed. Do we say migu b'makom chazaka or not? That's a lamdish shayla. So in other words, guys, on one hand, the chazaka says you didn't pay mitoch zman. On the other hand, it's after the zman already, and he could have said I paid you on the day it was due. And I didn't say that, but I could have said that. Believe me, I paid mitoch zman. Migu, I could have said I paid you bisman, and he wouldn't be believed. So now you have a migu. Can I get a chazaka? Iboiluhu. Tiboilu achazman. The amaloi praiticha bitoch zmani. Mahu. Mi aminon b'makom chazaka aminon mali l'shaker. B'makom chazaka, in this case, that I didn't pay up, we'll say mali l'shaker will believe the migu. Idilma b'makom chazaka loy aminon mali l'shaker. Let's see the top Rashi. Idilma. Since we're muchzik, that a person doesn't pay mitoch zman, we don't say migu in a place where there's chazaka. The marilu debure malu the shaker ulem nua. In other words, despite the fact that he's got a migu, nonetheless the chazaka is we will not go ahead. We won't allow him to say it because the chazaka, his words are connected to chazaka. So good, you could have timed it better, but we won't say it b'makom the chazaka. That's the shaila. So now, we're going to have the same Gemara we had yesterday, and we're going to bring in our Mishnah to be poshet what? The Shaila. We have the same Gemara as yesterday, and we're going to bring in the Mishnah to be poshet the Shaila. Tashma. Becheska shenasan. The wall is the following. Let's go to the Mishnah again outside. Guys, let's go to the Mishnah outside. You have two people, they agreed to build a wall. They didn't have to, they agreed to build a wall, right? Up to four Amis. Right? A guy tines that what? You didn't pay me. Chazaka, you paid. Why? Because since you didn't have to build it in the first place, there's no way you're starting to build it without the other guy's help. So you won't be believed to say that what? Unless you have Aiden up to four Amis. Because that is what's necessary for Hezek Re'iyah, four Amis. Now, anything above four Amis is gravy. That's you don't need to do that. So if this guy tines that what? They're going to build it higher than four Amis. And this guy says, you didn't pay up. The other guy is not believed to say he paid up. By the four Amis, which you do it, that he's not going to start without it, that he's taka believed. But above that, not. Good. So with those two dinim of the Mishnah, we want to go ahead and try to be Pesha Shaila. Do you say Miga B'makom Chazaka or not? That's what we're going to try to do. So now. The lower he has to do. Lower he has to do. Four Amis he has to do. Above four he doesn't have to do. We don't believe him.
If you don't believe him, why do you believe him on the bottom?
Because the bottom is not going to. Because it's something that Rashi said he's not going to start doing it unless he pays him up. I mean, we have to divide up the chutz. Me and you. You in a million years you're starting to build it without me giving you money. Yes or no? Of course not. That's why. Now above where you don't have to do. You don't have to do that. Would you build it if you want to? It's your druthers. You know, you have a. That's the difference. Clearly the difference. So now, says the Gemara. Toshma, b'cheska shenasan, the chazak on the four amis that he gave it, at shiyavi raya shloi nasan. The toiveya, the one who's claiming that you didn't give me the money, has to bring a raya. Now, hey, dummy, what exactly is he claiming? Ilei m'shetavoy la'achas man, if he's claiming after this man, v'omaloi, and the guy says, paticha bizmani, I paid in this man, pshita. Guys, no chiddush, right? You're claiming after this man, I said I paid you on the day it's due. What's the chiddush? El alav, it must be the amalei praticha b'toichzmani. It must be said that what I paid in toichzman, and he's believed. Alma afil b'makam chazaka amri mali l'shaka. We have, you know, it's believe me that what I could have said afterwards. Like, why I could have said afterwards. Believe me, I said now. Migo, I could have said afterwards. Doesn't work. Shiny hacha the chol shafa b'shafa zmani hu. As we said. There's no mitoich zman over there because each row that you put up, it's not pshat when you finish the job. It's each row you put up is considered mitoich zman. Therefore, that's the same gemara as yesterday. Toshma, and this is going on the midal amusul mailo. We're not mechayiv a person to go edvan and put that up. Why? Because there's no hezekriya anymore. Up to four amus is hezekriya. Samech lo kaisel acher. However, if he puts another kaisel next to words, then what? Then he shows he's milgalim as a kol. He's going to go ahead. You're going to say he has to pay everything, guys. Remember, he's putting a wall like this. Look, he has a wall here. He's putting a wall over here to put a ticker across the top to make a on his side of the wall to make a little, you know, cubby or something over there. Now, if he says he paid up, we're not going to believe him. Says the Gemara. Samach kaisel acher at shiavi raish nasan hechi dami ilay mishetov lachas manoi. He's tavei after this man. V'amalei praticha bismani. My loy, why is he not believed? Elolav, the Amar, it must be speaking, the Amarlei, praticha b'teichzmani. And now, Alma b'mokim chazaka, loy amin amali v'shaker. Since he's not believed, you see that what? B'mokim chazaka, that you don't pay up b'teichzmani, he's not believed. So the first part of the Mishnah, we want to bring a raya, he is believed. The second part, we want to bring a raya, he's not believed. It says, M'shani hacha. The same terrace as yesterday. You know why he's not believed? Not because a person is not believed. Really, you would be believed. But over here, you put up this wall. I'm putting up this wall. How do I know that Chacham is going to be mechayev me? So therefore, he's not believed because maybe he'll get away with it. You know, it's not so pashut. Maybe he'll get away with it. And therefore, you don't have a raya. So it remains in a bayad lo yifshita. So I think we're going to try one more time. Amalei Ravacha b'rei the Ravashi, Toshma. Mana li biyadcha, you have a mana, $100 of mine in your hands. Amalai hin, he says yes, and they're edim that he said yes. And lemachar amalai tenu li, and the next day he says give it to me. Imam anasativ lach, if he says I gave it to you, hater. If he says ein lecha biyadi, but I don't have it, chayiv. My lav nesaticha lov, damalai praticha bizmani. That I pay bisman, therefore he's pater. Ein lecha biyadi damle praticha b'toich zmani b'katani chayiv, that you chayiv to pay. So the assumption is I gave it to you, meaning I gave it to you b'toich zman. So therefore, migu b'machm chazaka, alma b'machm chazaka loy amin amali l'shaker loy. My ein lecha biyadi lehoyi devar me'olam lahadam. In other words, didn't say I paid him b'toich zman. I never. Now, why is he not believed? Because he had aided him the night before that he's masking that he did give it. He had aid him that he did give it. So Amar Mar, call anyone who says I didn't borrow, claim a lay prati dummy. No, but he already said the day before that he borrowed the money. Let's see Rashi on this. Fourth line down. Hilkach. Chayiv l'shalim is chayiv to pay. For yesh aidim shahayiv the lebefneim. You have aid him that is moid in front of them that he paid, that he owed him the money. The kim in the Amar loy levisi. Now he's saying I didn't borrow moidahu shle para. He's being moited, they didn't pay up. So call me Shane Aloiva in a pareya. Anyone who doesn't borrow doesn't pay up. Hilkach koimele prati dummy. It's like if he said, I didn't pay up. Diloma prati, if he would have said, I paid up, Neman, he would have been believed. I feel a loiva befneim. Even if he fayed him. The kaimelan shvuas amavas rebe rebeidim, and tsarchwe rebeidim. Okay, so now, guys, the bottom line is you weren't pleasure the Shiloh. Bottom line is, you want to push the Shiloh. What was that Shiloh? We began to share. Shiloh is, we have a chazaka, a person doesn't pay a bitach zman like Reish Lakish. What happens after this man, he claims I paid up bitach zman? believe me, I paid up mitach zman. Nigra, I could have said I paid bizman. Or bechazak is stronger. We try to be paisha the shaila, and we weren't successful. The last case, monli biyotcha, it's not a case of what, like you thought of speaking about a case that you lend money in front of eight. You said Adim say, oh, $100. Adim hear that. The next day you say, where is it? The guy says, I paid you up. He's believed. If he says, I gave it. I lend a saticha. You didn't give it to me. Not believed. Lahadam. Right. So lahadam means what? That since you said the day before that what that you owe the money, and now you're saying lelevisi. Lelevisi is like play parati, and therefore you have to pay up. But again, you aren't pressure the shaila at all. So a little digression in our mesechta. We said again, this guy's the outside. What's the case? He built a wall, 4 amis high, and then another 4 amis, 8 amis. How much does he have to pay? 4 amis. The other 4 is extra. He now puts an 8 amis wall next to it. What's the din? Yes, the whole thing. What happens if he puts a 6 amis wall next to it? Now he's only using up 2 of the upper 4. Does he pay the whole thing? Does he pay only partial? He had a shiloh. Says the Gemara. If he goes ahead what and he puts it to 6, then he samach the whole thing. In other words, eventually, says Rashi, he has no use of it if it's not going to reach the top of the wall. He has no use of it if it's not going to reach the top of the wall. So therefore, if even at 6 amis, you're going to pay for 8. Again, the extra 4, right? At 6 amis, you're going to pay for 4. Instead of 2, you're going to pay 4. But Nachmanama, Lemaida Samach Samach, no, whatever he was, it was. Whatever it was. In other words, in my scenario, you're only gonna pay for 2 amis. So Loy Rav Huna, you're gonna pay for 4 amis, even though you only built a bot 2. And according to Rav Nachman, you're only gonna pay for 2. Umaida Rav Huna's Maida, Bikarna Vilufsa. Rashi brings it seems that his house is coming, one of the walls is abutting his house. I'm not exactly sure what it looks like, but the bottom line is the heft that he built up is a parallel wall will view it as an extension of his house. When you view it as an extension of his house, then he's moida that you don't have to pay for it, or the whole thing. That you'd pay for the whole thing. Okay, Rashi says, these guys, look at me. Here is the wall, it's 8 amas high. Here's the wall, 6 amas high. The 6 amas high wall, he put a beam across. You know, when he puts a beam across, it means he wants to finish the job. Or over here, he goes ahead and he puts little, he carves out like little windows and places he's going to place the beams. So if he does something like that, even Rav Nachman would be moida, you pay for the whole thing. Even Rav Nachman would be moida, you pay for the whole thing. First scenario, again, it seems to be an extension of the house. I'm exactly sure to picture it. So, but that's each one has one as you know. It's if it's an extension. Then he's Huna's mighty only pay for that amount and that above. And if it's you put beams on top of it or you carve out that you can see that you can put beams there, then Rav Nachman says that what you be mighty, you pay for the whole thing. Rav Huna beikavi loy havi chazaka. Okay, now beikavi. If you go ahead and you let's see Rashi guys. But before it gets wide, 4 lines up. Bekavi are windows. Lo yavi chazaka. Shimon sheik bia koisel hacholik b'chotzer l'maylam b'dalan amis. Shimon elevates a koisel that divides a chotzer above 4 amis. V'yosebach haloynes litzad Ruvain, and he makes windows on Ruvain's side. La'anochas roishe koires. In other words, Shimon is the one who built it up, but he put on Ruvain's side those places for the beams. Right, you hear? So it's not a chazaka that Ruvain has to pay. Continues Rashi. K'moshe parashti, loy habi chazaka legabe Ruvain. It's not a chazaka regarding Ruvain. Lemar anisa iticha. I financially helped him lagbia. Shelule sheisa iticha la yisi oisli hanachas kairos. Because if I didn't help him, he wasn't going to put a place for kairos. In other words, Ruvain didn't do it. Shimon did it. So you might think that Shimon kind of look Ruvain, he must have done it, right? It's not a chazaka. Shim over lismach le kaisel achel achasman. Okay, so now we have enough. Says Rashi. Says the Gemara now. Beikavi, if you have holes on the other side, so Shimon who put up the 8 amis, he makes holes on the other side. Lo yavi chazaka that Ruvain's gonna did it. But afagav the overlay him himlati. Even he would put slats, guys. You know what they go ahead? They put slats to go ahead and they wouldn't get absorbed from the moisture of the walls. So they put like kind of insulation slats. Even if he does that, Damale, because Ruvain can tie na amina lachi paisili, because I loy lisra ishtoi, that when you mafias me, you shouldn't go ahead what and weaken my wall. In other words, why is it, why the reason he did that is because, let's say, guys, Shimon's after himself. Because what happens, guys? Shimon builds the wall, and now Reuven didn't the extra wall. Shimon's not part of it. Not part of it. Now Shimon has the foresight to do what? If I'm going to let Reuven start hacking that wall, who knows what's going to be? So I'll go ahead while the construction's still going on, and I'll put them in there. So therefore, it's not a riot that what that Reuven put them in there. Shimon put them in there. Why did Shimon put them in there? Because then Reuven started breaking the wall down later. But okay, now. The next piece of Gemara is very interesting. Fellas, outside, we know this Shalosh Shalom Chazak, we spoke about this many times. The third perek in this Masechta is the most famous yeshivish perek in Shas, for sure. Up, right up there. Cheska Sabatim. Cheska Shalosh Shonim. A guy's on your field for 3 years. Come to him, you say, what are you doing here? He says, I bought it from you. Where's your shtar? I don't have it. He's believed, right? He's believed. Because the person, if you're in that field, you should have made a macho, you should have gone ahead and said something. What about chazaka in something else? What about chazaka if it's shtamshus, fellas? A chazaka of using something. So let's see Rashi. Rashi, five lines down. In the middle of Rashi, it says, achzik lehurdi. Achzik lehurdi. 4 lines down where it gets right. Kol chazakas halalu, all the chazakas that we're about to embark upon, the shmaitza of this sugya, Eina chazaka shalosh shanim. It's not speaking chazaka of 3 years. Leishayach shalosh shanim elagabe cheskas karka. Shalosh shanim is only shayach by karka. Shemachzik b'sada chaveiroi. You're going here. You're holding on to your friend's field. V'ayim elakachtiv mimcha. I bought it from you. Amalacha b'cheskas tashmishim ba'alma mayri. Here we're speaking the chazaka. You have a chazaka of usage. Shemeshtamish b'shal chaveiroi. You're using your friend's property for whatever was or his object. You used it once in front of him. It's a chazaka. Come on, the amrinon, as we'll see. And if he puts cement on it right away, have a chazaka. The time of mishum the amrinon leshavik inish lishnemushay b'toch shaloi tash mishal kaviyus loy reshus like no person is going to allow you to use his property right and without saying something. And since he was in front of him, he went ahead and he did something. What are we going to say? We're going to say that what that he gave him a shus, or he gave him money, or machle tashmizeh. Behani mili dava chazaka going shetoinu machle. He sold it to me and nasli matana. Alvontoyin ishtamashti befana b'shus like in a chazaka. It's got to be coming to taina. Every chazaka has to have a taina. Okay, guys, geschmack. So now the sugi is speaking about what. Chazaka of Ishtamshus. And how when is it chazaka? When you do it in front of the guy, he doesn't say anything. And your taina, he sold me the rights to do this. That's the next piece of Gemara. With that in mind, let's begin. Rav Nachman, achzik lehurdi. If you have a chazaka of hurdi, you leave little slats at the top of a wall. Loi achzik lekshuri. You're not muchzik for what? For heavy beams. In other words, just because he lets you put light beams on top of the wall does not mean he's mishtamish that lets you put heavy beams on top of the wall. Likshuri, however, heavy beams, achzik lehurdi. That would be muchzik for what? For light beams. Rabbi Yosef Amar, achzik lehurdi, achzik likshuri. You know, you either you own the rights to the wall or not. In other words, Rabbi Yosef's of the opinion, fellas, you own rights to the wall, you can put anything you want there. Ikudi Amri, Rav Nachman, Achzik Lahudi, Achzik Kshuri, the Kshuri, Achzik Lahudi, Rav Nachman, okay, says Rav Nachman, Achzik Lenatfe, there's water coming off a roof and it's dripping in the Chatzar, but Natfe is Lush and Nataf, it's dripping in different places. Achzik Lashavke, then you'll be Machzik for one gutter letting the water out. It seems the gutter letting the water out is better than what drip, 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 drip. Achzik Lashavke, if you Achzik for the gutter, Loy Achzik Lenatfe. Then why? Because natve is more cumbersome. It's more difficult to take. you're messing up the chutzah. Rav Yosef, I mean, Rav Yosef is of the opinion, afilu achzik l'shavke, even if you achzik l'shavke, even if you're machzik for a gutter, achzik l'natfe. Mordechai, tafav am aleph, three lines in the bottom. Ikad the Yami Amr of Nachman, achzik l'shavke, achzik l'natfe, l'natfe, achzik l'shavke, either one. Either one you will be worked for. If even the gutter would work for dripping, dripping work for the gutter. Aval at Tzifa de Urvani, it seems that this is a hut that it has a. We met Tzifa de Urvani in. I think you have to if you put in the sugya of Tchilas Peshiyah of a slave bonus that you put money in there. You put money in there. It's Peshiyah burning. It's bonus that it was stolen, something like that. Anyway, the water seems to go down and very very strong. In other words, this is even bigger a bigger shter than what than shavke. Light, right? I said, I feel it's for the Urvani, even if it's a hut, the thatched roof of palm fronds, it's going to go ahead and be a problem. Not going to be a problem. Rav Yosef Uvda Betzir for the Urvani, and Rav Yosef Uvda Betzir for the Urvani, and he let the person want that he's machzik for Tzir for the Urvani as well. Rav Nachman, Rav Avua, Hamaskle Bayis Lechaveira, someone goes ahead and rents a bias to his friend, Bibiri Gedoyla. Says Rashi, what are we speaking about? Says Rashi, Bibiri Gedoyla. Bayis Aruch, it's a very long house, Ma'oid, the Cholak Metoichel Lahabe Chadorim, and inside it's divided up to many different roofs, many different roofs. The Hichsel Lizeh Echmehem, and he rents a room. Arizem Mishtamish Bekoislecha, he can go ahead and be Mishtamish with the walls, Becholwek Haksolim, that means what? With the holes in the walls. I'll pay Orcha, Mibachutz, on the outside, Ad Dalet Amos, up till Dalet Amos from his apartment. Afshalay Kneged Besai, even not Kneged his house. In other words, let's say, guys, look at my hand. This is his house. He's living over here. You don't need him over here, opposite over here. As long as it's within 4 amos of that, you'll be able to use the walls. As long as it's 4 amos of my apartment, this is the apartment, my backside. This is the chutz in front. You have a wall over here. You'll be able to use the holes of the wall to put crevices of the walls to put things in. And not only that, bezizin. They had these seasoned projectiles would come out like, look at a Mexican hacienda. You have the things coming out of the walls. They'd hang their laundry on it, different things. Good? So if you rent it, you have a right to use a shtamshis within 4 amis outside the wall, guys. You could use for ksolim, adal amis. And if you rent a top, if you rent the penthouse, uba'ibi a kaisel, even at the top of the kaisel, okay, bimokim shenogu, avo bitar bitzapad ne loy. Seems to be they have in the lobby. I'm calling it the lobby. They have a garden planted there. So the wall opposite the garden you couldn't use because you don't want the laundry hanging in a nice. It's there for the scene. It's for aesthetic look, right? The aesthetic look. You don't want the guys, you know, kachkas over there, right? You know, hanging over there. So avoroch bo shachuri abatim. Interesting enough, the backs of the house that you can't use. Avoroch bo shachuri abatim loy. Rav Amar, I feel a rach b'shachur b'atim. Even the backyard, you're able to go ahead and use the walls and the bat and the projectiles. Amar Avina, hay kishur d'matal talta. Okay, here you have a beam. Kishur de metal talta, right? You have a beam that is you have it on a roof. You have this beam, and it's what? It's going what? It's going to the roof. Tosfos says, "I'm Rabbeinu Tam Damastisan Koy." It's going on the Mishnah. Da'at Shloshim Yoyim Lehavi Chazaka. Until 30 days is not a Chazaka. Ba'vecheska Shlei Nosam Nosan. That you didn't pay up before 30 days. Mekam ve'elach havi becheskas shenasan. V'yasa shapid the nakid hachav le becheskas abatim. In other words, why do we learn this over here? Not becheskas abatim, right? So what's the case? Keshura demetatalta. So now the chazaka al tilsin yomim loy havi chazaka. 30 days. If you have a keshura, if you have a beam going across to a person's roof, and up to 30 days is not a chazaka. Meaning that you could use there forever. You have a chazaka to go ahead and store your stuff there. You know, you're putting a beam across. Do you have a chazaka that you could always do that or not? Right? Lo yavi chazaka. Rashi says, "Im somcha al kaisel chaveroi, loy micha b'teich shloishim yoyim." If you put your the beam on the wall of your friend, and he doesn't say anything for 30 days, then I'm able to use it forever. For 30 days, the person's not makbid, and therefore he didn't say anything. He needs it for shade. In a few days, he's going to take it away. So Rashi, easy to understand. Guys, we know, in other words, in the sugya of way Rashi's learning is an extension of this sugya. Rashi Tosis is going back on the four. Rashi's learning is going on an extension over here. We're speaking about chazaka v'shtamshus. So you have a wall, and this guy has, he put his beam across the wall, and he's sitting there in his beach chair. For 30 days, the fact that he's using it is not a chazaka, because the person's not makbid. He says, again, he's going to go away. After 30 days, if you see him doing it and you let him do it, then it's a chazaka that what? He bought that right. It's a chazaka that he bought that right. But till siyam alay have a chazaka, but till siyam alay have a chazaka. The sukkah de mitzvah he, and if it's a sukkah of a mitzvah, ad, metalata means like the shade. Kshur metalata means the shade. It's a beam of shade. The sukkah de mitzvah he, ad shiva yamim, lay have a chazaka, bacha shiva yamim have a chazaka. Right? Rashi brings, look at Rashi, interesting enough. Since he left it more than he should have, he should have said something. Now notice in Rashi, very interesting. It says Tosfos over here. You have Tosfos in Rashi, guys. Very, very strange, right? And if you notice Rashi throughout the Hagoyos and Rashi, you don't look at Rashi. I'll show you something very fascinating. If you go back to Daf Dalet on the base. So the Mishnah says, "Emichayim nasei." Look at Rashi, guys. "Emichayim nasei." Says Rashi, "Lost his klum kedaminim b'stam bika makim shenagush leligdahu haga tuf min shen." What is that? Right? What is that? Good. So Shmuley Bornstein, he quoted the Dikduke Seifrim that stands for Taisvis Merenu Shmuel. This is the Rashbam. The Rashbam, who is going to be the primary Mefarish and Masechta, right, later on. But even here, when Rashi wrote his Pirish, the Rashbam was commenting on him, Endi. Tuf Mem Shin, Paisefes, Mishnas, Mirabenu, Shmuel. That's Rashi's grandchild. Rashi had a daughter. You know, Rabbeinu Tam and Rashbam were brothers. They were brothers. Hey, guys, you hear this? Yehudi, yeah? Tuf Shemen, Paisefes, Mirabenu Shmuel. So you see that interjected into these pshatim are is the taisvah. Rashbam is a taisvah, by taisvah. So interjected. So you have also here you have taisvah interjecting over here. So that what that pissed 7 days, you're ready. Then awesome. I'm going to leave it there. But after 7 days, then it's going to be a chazaka if you don't get rid of it. Says the Gemara Vayta. V'chavrei betina, if he puts the beam he lets him put the beam immediately with mud, with cement. Al tavi chazaka. Immediately it's a chazaka. Immediately it's a chazaka. Hesh, you had a question?
Well, you were saying move the sukkah. So it's just 7 days, but after that it's no longer sukkah. So the fact
that he let him keep it there is a riot that is not for the mitzvah, and therefore it's a chazaka. That's the point. Okay? Anyway, Amar Abaya. Now we're going back to the sugya of Hezekiah. Guys, we're going back to the sugya of Hezekiah. We had the sugya of Ishtamshus, of using of Tashmishim, and now we're going back to what the sugya of Hezekiah. What's the shear for Hezekiah? What's the shear? Dalit Amis, right? Dalit Amis. Fascinating. Says Amar Abaya. Shnei Batim b'shnei tzidei Rishus Harabim. You have two houses on two sides of the Rishus Harabim. Okay, guys, look at me. Here's a house, and here's a house, and you have my head is the Rishus Rabbim in between. Good. We said earlier that on a gag, that usually a mica for a gag is 10 tefachim. But if you're forced to put up one before Amis, it's because of Hezekiah. And therefore, if you're on this roof and I'm on this roof and there's Rishus Rabbim between, I don't know when you're going to use the roofs. So now we can make you do what? put up two full walls, but that's not necessary. We can shorten things. If you put one in the south side and I put one in the north side, so we're covered because I'm going to be behind the north. And as long as you go ahead and add a little bit in the middle so you can't see in the diagonal. Right? So that's what you're doing over here. You're going ahead and it's a Hezek Re'iyah issue. And instead of you're putting up Dalet Amos and that's what you're doing. I'm Rabbi. Shtei batim shtei tzidei rishus rabim. Zoi semaikol lechatzi gagoi. Zoi semaikol lechatzi gagoi. Zeh shaloi keneged zeh. One on the south side, one on the north side. Umadif, and you add a little bit. Okay, each person extends a little piece bit halfway point. Very good. So my ear rishus rabim. I feel rishus hayochid nami. Now, the Rashbam speaks out the following. Fellas, guys, if you have one gag and another gag next to each other, you don't have to... Since the shtamshus there is so not set, and you can see each other, all you'd have to just demarcate, but you wouldn't have to put up a full wall, because you could avoid the guy. When, however, says the Rashba, it's separate, then you don't know. Afraid the Rashba kasha, learning Pshat Gemara's kasha. You're telling me in our case, my head being the Shusarabim. Since what they don't, there's a hefsek in between. You need a wall. So what do you care about Rishus Rabim? Even if my head was Rishus Hayachid, you'd still have the same problem. You'd have to put up a wall because there's a in between. That's the Gemara's kasha. Says the Gemara, my ear you Rishus Rabim, my feel Rishus Hayachid nami. Says the Rishus Rabim mitzrichle. You need the chiddush Rishus Rabim. Ma'u detayim aneim alei soif soif haboyis letzta'uye mi beiv Rishus Rabim. In other words, why do I have to put up a wall? You have to put up a wall. Why? Because of B'nai Rishus Rabim. So you put up a wall. And if I'm not Makban, I'm not. In other words, if you're Makban and Hezek Re'iyah, you go put up. Guys, what does Hezek Re'iyah do? Hezek Re'iyah is Mechayiv me to put up a wall. We spoke it out, right? It's not like Ayin Hara, which is Niskei Mammon. Hezek Re'iyah means you're Mechayiv to put up a wall. So forget about me. Rishus Rabim, you know, you got to worry about people. So therefore, it's not the fact that I could see into you. You have to put up a wall, the fact that people could see into you. So that's the chiddush over here. Despite the fact he can tie into that, he can retort the following. Slave Saif, he could tell the following. Guess what? Hezek Re'iyah is, but Rishus Rabim is only during the day, but you is day and night. Therefore, he can force him. Inami, Rabim ki kamina chazili. When I stand up, they see me. Ki asivne, when I'm sitting, loy chazili. They don't see me. At, but you who are elevated, at chazili ben ki kaimna ben ki kasivna. You see me whether what. So either way, so therefore you can force him. Rabim ki ma'aini chazili, ki loy ma'ani loy chazili. Only when they look, you loy at memela nami chazili. In other words, for the B'nai Rishus Rabim to shter me, they have to look and work at it. By saying you, who's right there, it's very easy. So three reasons why you can tie that you have to put up a roof. Amamar, going back over the din we just stated. Zeh ois the Michael lechatzi gagoi, v'zeh ois the Michael lechatzi gagoi. Zeh shloi keneged zeh u'ma'adif. Pshita, it's pashat. I mean, why not? It's pashat. Rashi says, the high palga, the high palga. Why would you think otherwise? Like Tzricha, the Kodem Chaminayim V'Ovid. One went ahead and he put it up. One went ahead and V'Ovid Didei. So Ma'u Ditema, Neim Lecha, Idach, Shokol Uzinka, V'Ovdi Eskula, Kamash Malan. Fellas, look, guys, look at me. What's Hezek Re'iyah? You're stared by somebody, right? So you got two guys in the Shusha Rabim. This guy goes ahead and puts up a wall, puts up a half a wall. Puts up a half a wall. What is he showing? That is, he's shtered. So the guy over here can say, listen, you're shtered? Guess what? Put up a full wall, I'll pay you for the other half. Kamash Malon, he can't tell him that. Kamash Malon, he's got to put up the half on his side. In other words, you think of Svara, you saw Mac, but you put up your half, put the full thing on your side, you don't have to worry about Hezek Re'iyah, and I'll pay you. Kamash Malon, no, that palga, each one has to put up the half. Again, Mercy asking, Pshita, each one has to put up a half. Says the Gemara, no, maybe one person puts up a hole. Here's the Svara. Says the Gemara, Damalei, at my time of Avdis, what's the reason you don't do it in the first place? Mishun de Misrari Ishisach. It's going to ruin your wall. I'm not Nami, Mr. Elias, you saw you. It's going to be my wall. In other words, a half a wall I can take, but a full, I don't, a full weight of a full wall I don't want. So you go ahead, you put half on yours, half on mine. That's the time. Amrav Nachman Mishmuel. Gag has somech l'chotzah ha-beiroi. A gag that's next to the chotzah, right next to it. Oisle maka gavoye dalet amis. He makes a mica for amis. Not 10 tfachim, but for amis. Al sezek riyah. Avo ben gag l'gag loy. Again, as the gag when they're next to each other, as I told you, there's no, remember the Rashba, there's nothing being masik in between. Ben gag l'gag loy. Why? Because you can see the guy. Rav Nachman didei omar, ein ezokik l'dalet amis. Avo zokik l'michitzis asara, 10 tfachim. Says the Lamai. What are you worried about? Ila has this kriya. If Ben Gagla Gagas has the kriya, Arba Amis Bino. You need four Amis. Ila Nitfas Lokagan. If the guy is coming into your chutzer or your to your gag and you want to chop him as a ganif, then Besipas Baal Masagi, it should be enough. What? 10. Ila Gedim Taloyim. If it's Bichde Shle Yistaker, Bas Roish Sagi. And if you're. And. Three tefachim is enough to do the job. In other words, ila hasik riyah arba amis bina ila nifas lov kagana b'mesivas balma. Mesivas balma, guys, doesn't mean 10 tefachim. It means wad, even pegs. You know, just going ahead wad and excuse me, I made a mistake. Mesivas balma, so earlier, those are pegs demarcating the difference. Ila gediyim v'taloyim, and if the shear of gediyim taloyim, this is the sugya, guys, of lovewood, gediyim boikimba, right? B'chtei shle yiztach v'vas roish sagi, which is three tefachim. So where do you get what? Where do you get 10 tefachim, guys? Why 10 tefachim? In Manu Shach. If you're worried about Hezek Riyah, it's what? It's 4. If you're not worried about Hezek Riyah, and just for Ganeth, either in Mesipas Balma or 3 tefachim. Loilam Linifas Lovke Ganeth. The Mesipas Matzi Mishtamishle. Take out the words. Rashi doesn't have the next brackets. Guys, you know what a guy does? You have a, you don't have a wall. You have just a barrier, right? He puts a, he throws. He wants to steal from you. He takes one of his objects and throws it on the other side, jumps over the fence. And what is he, Taina? I'm going to get that, right? Because I'm going to get that. Look at Rashi, guys. 3 lines down where it gets wide at the end of the line. Matzi mishtametle, he can slip away. V'loimar. Chayfetz nafel miyadi, al gagoch. Chayfetz from my hands fell on your roof. And if that's the est chalitol, and I entered what? To go ahead and get it. I entered to go, going. I went entered to go ahead and get it. So mechitza asar le'matzim mishtamet le. A chitza of 10 tefachim, you can't do that. And therefore, 10 tefachim and not besifas ba'alma. Meisivei, we're going to ask Rav Nachman. Again, Rav Nachman says 10 tefachim, and we're worried about what? About ganavim. Ein nisik le'dal ramis. I skip. Meisivei, im hoye chatzer le'may le'mi gag v'shal chabeiroi. Let's say your chatzer was above the gag. Guys, this is the opposite. This guy has a raised chatzer. And the roof of the guy is below. We don't force him. My love ain't a skokin like klal. We don't force him at all. Now, if you worry about a ganif, then you should go ahead at least put up 10 tefachim. Loi. Ain't a skokin like dalet amis, am a skokin like mechitza asara. We don't force him. We don't force dalet amis, but we force what? Mechitza asara. Itmar. Shtei chatzeroi, zu lemaylem yizu. You got 2 chatzeros, one on top of the other. Okay, they're not, again, they're not next to each other, one above each other. Amrav Huna, tachtoim boina mikenegdoi. The tachtoim builds up till he reaches the level. So guys, like this, look at this. Look at my hands. So the bottom guy has to pay till he gets to here. And once they get above, then they split it. Okay, once they get above, then they split it. Rav Chista Amar, Elyon Messiah Milmata, the Elyon even helps the bottom guy, Ubaina. Tanya Kabasi Rav Chista, that even the bottom guy, the top guy helps the bottom guy. Shtei Chazer Zulam Avizu, La Yomer Elyon Hareini Boina Mekenegdi, the Elyon should say, I'm going to build next to me, Voila, El Messiah Milmata, Ubaina. He goes ahead, right? He helps the other guy below, and they build. Vimhoye Chatser Lamaila Migago Shal Chaveroi, right? And if his Chatser was above the Gag of his friend, if his chutzah was above, then you can't force him to go ahead and build.